and leave the and give the word to Bishop Faure.
Right. Thank you, Father. Well, so twice in Latin America, I have heard of the first time by an archbishop of Paraná in Argentina. I spoke to him of my vocation, but that I would like to defend very particularly the tradition. And he told me, but all of us, we are to, this is our job, to defend the tradition. But if you want really to defend the tradition, I knew bishop in the second, in the Vatican II, in the council, and we have fought to defend the tradition. And he's Bishop Lefebvre. He's French, as you are. And I thought to go to Econ, and I would have been the first seminary of the society. But just in that time, I heard of the accident where one of my friends in Mexico died. So I had to go back to help his family and his sons. And two or three years after, we received some Swiss, people of Switzerland, to speak us about apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And with them was a priest of Rides. Rides is a city where is Econ. And we had some friends in France, the same friends, so we invite them to have a coffee in our house. And they told us that some of their friends in Switzerland offers a house to a French bishop to do something for the tradition. And it was Bishop Lefebvre. So once in Argentina, in South America, and after in the north, in Mexico, twice the Providence told me, if you want to work for tradition, for the church, for the faith, go with Bishop Lefebvre. And I met him in Switzerland. There was only 12 seminarians. It was the beginning, but I was always in Catholic schools before the council, and so I recognized a true Catholic bishop, Monseigneur Bishop Lefebvre. And I entered in 72 when many seminarians come, because it was the second year of more seminarians. And this year there were 34 seminarians. One of them was Father Black, who is here in Australia, good friend. And the other was Bishop Williamson. And it was very beautiful for us, because in a church dominated by the dictature of the progressists, of the liberals, we had, at least, it was a miracle, a seminary with thousands of books, with a Catholic bishop. It was wonderful. But very soon, the problems began, because many seminarians and some professors, teachers, went to this seminary because it was the only one that was Catholic. In France, it was anything. In France, some years before, in a Catholic church, a young priest with a cassock told us during the les cours,
during the lessons,
of religion, they destroyed all the supernatural in the Bible. They said that the miracles were exaggerations, the prophecies were not prophecies. For instance, Isaiah. Isaiah was a great man, and he had disciples, a school of disciples, une école. And then, of course, his disciples follow the lessons of the maître,
master.
Of the master. And so, it was like newspapers. They just said what was occurring some centuries later. But so there was not prophecy of Isaiah. No, no, it was just the history. And so if, and that was what they were taught in the seminary. So if in the Bible you have no more prophecies, no more miracles, no more supernatural facts, you have no longer signature of God. Because God says that the prophets are writing on the order of God, and he has to say, this man says the truth. What is the proof? What are the proof? The proof are the miracles and the prophecies. No other. And so they said that the Bible was une chanson de geste.
Was a mythical book.
Poetry and Hebrew, Midrash, conte de fées.
A fairy tale.
Fairy tale. So if for the seminarians the Bible are fairy tale, if they do not pray, no rosary, that is for all the ladies, and if the studies of philosophy, theology are all in a revolution, so the normal boys will go out and marry, of course. And many that will stay in the seminary are boys that are not interested by marriage.
By matrimony.
By matrimony. And so, of course, they say now that there was a plan to infiltrate the church with homosexuals. And so we had so many scandals in the United States and till the Vatican now.
Australia. L'Australie est justement dans un scandale parce que le cardinal Pearl a un scandale d'affaires de mœurs qu'il a maltraité, qu'il a mal géré à Melbourne.
Yes, Father told me of a scandale in Melbourne, but it is in all the world. In France, we had a bishop, Monseigneur Gaillot. He says, as the Bible, our Lord says, the prostitutes, he says to the Pharisees, the prostitutes will enter before you in the reign of God. So this Monseigneur Gaillot of Évreux in France says, the homosexuals will enter before you in the reign of God. And he writes that in a revue.
In a newspaper.
In a magazine of gays in France. And le gay pied. And and this year, in the most well-known magazine of the States, you had the gays, no? The man of the year, Francis. Ah. I hope it was the man. It's horrible. No? Oh. And it is interesting. Many big magazines in the world says Francis, the man of the year. And all these magazines are of the enemies of the faith, enemies of the church. So for somebody who uses a little his mind, it is very clear, no? So I encounter Bishop Lefebvre in the Holy Week of 72. And I was in Rome on the 29th of June of 72, and I have heard with my ears the Pope Paul VI says, after the Council we hoped a wonderful time for the Church, but we are in a tempest, in the confusion. It looks like if the smoke of Satan had entered into the church by a crack. And many of these popes say the same thing. For instance, Benedict XVI said, no, now the church is like a sinking boat in which the water enters in many places. So they see that the boat is sinking, but they don't understand why it's sinking. They say, no, it's because of the press, because of the TV, because of internet, because... But no. The cause is the revolution of the Council, Vatican II, of course. And they speak of auto-destruction, auto-demolition of the Church. What does it mean? It means that the Church, people, men of the Church, are destroying the Church. Shall we obey to these men who are destroying the Church? Bishop Lefebvre was a little retired in the last years of his life. And he read much. And he read the books of Father Emmanuel Barbier, who were edited in 1924. And Bishop Lefebvre said, if I would have read again these books, I would have given another formation to my seminarians. It means more anti-liberal and anti-modernist formation. And these books are very interesting. It is easy to find them in internet, in French, and to edit them. Sin Monet. And in the introduction, Father Barbier, his book is History of the Catholicism Liberal. He says that these ideas of the Masonry were like torpedoes to destroy the Catholic monarchies in Europe, and they said we have to destroy the monarchies, the kings, to seize the power with democracy, and then we shall attack the altar, the church. And there is exactly this program, because once with thanks to democracy, they had the power, because the democracy is the power, is the authority of the banks, the banksters, as say Bishop Williamson. And the bank with the money, they have everything. They have the politics, they have the elections, they have the newspapers, they have the TV, they have everything. And so they can organize how the people must think. And so these ideas are the ideas of the Masonry. Liberté, égalité, fraternité. And these two programs of the Masonry, solve et coagula. Dissolver the institution, Catholic institutions of the ancien regime, and to build other associations. For instance, they destroy the corporations of the Middle Age, and they built the syndicates instead.
Trade unions.
And it was a triumph, because you had the revolution in England, later the revolution of 1789 in France, and later in 1917, the revolution in Russia. And this idea begins to invade all the society. And to some priests, like Félicité de la Menesse, just after Napoleon, in 1830, says, if we do not take this flag of liberty, of freedom, then we are lost. The church will lose. We have to fight against the revolution with the same ideas, liberté. And that was after the Sion, the Christian democracy, etc., etc. And that was the Catholicism liberal, who began to... So, Father Barbier says, four times this movement, heresy, of Catholicism liberal, grow. And he was to seize the power in the Church of France and in the papacy. And three times the popes cut the head of this movement. Gregory XVI with the encyclical Mirari Vos, and after Pius the Ninth, with the, you had the syllabus, and you had the Council Vatican First, with the infallibility of the Pope, and you had the Saint Pius the Tenth, who condemned the Catholicism liberal. Now, the Popes, Pius the Ninth, say the Catholicism liberal are the worst enemies of the Church, because they are inside. And Pope Pius X said, the modernists are the worst enemies of the Church, within the Church. And so these two enemies Finally, one. Because we must say it. It is. If you take in France Catholicism liberal, you say some sentences of the Larousse Encyclopedia. They say that they do not say with the same words, but it is meaning that the Pope, the Vatican, with the Pope Leon the 13th, with the reconciliation of the France, Catholic France, with the Republic, he just forgot that the Republic in France is the Masonry. No more. And so, this says, Encyclopédie Larousse, then the Catholicism liberal resuscitated. No? And after came Pius IX, who destroyed it. And after they said, of course, Saint Pius X also destroyed this heresy, but that this heresy was crushed by the school of thinking of the Action Française, Maurras. That was a movement anti-liberal and anti-modernist. Unfortunately, the Pope Pius XI was not well informed and he destroyed the Action Française, this anti-liberal movement. And that was very, very serious because it was a triumph of the left in the bishops, in the Church of France. And that is when, in 1926, they took off Father Leflocq, the director of the seminary of Bishop Lefebvre in Rome, a seminary for the future bishops of France. And they obliged Cardinal Biot, bright theologian, to surrender, to go out from the, to abandon the cardinal, the post of cardinal.
To present his demission as a cardinal.
As a cardinal, which is very, almost never that occurs. But in that case, and Cardinal Marty of Paris said, then we took the power, the Catholicism liberal and the modernist, and with the new theology, the same things, after the Second World War, they always go up, and the Pope Pius XII saw all these men who was nearby him, Cardinal Bea, many of the men who triumphed in the Vatican II were very near of the Pope. It was, and of course, when he died, then these men had their council. They have prepared this council for many times. The apostate priest Rocca told more or less one century before, we shall have a council and we shall change the church and we shall put our ideas in the church. And so began the Council Vatican II. The history is perfectly well known by the text of Michael Davis in England, Bishop Lefebvre, and everybody knows this history. It was a plot. It was a conjuration. Unfortunately, this plot was successful because one of these men was the Pope. The Popes. The Pope, friend of Bishop Montini, John Paul 23rd, after Paul VI, John Paul II, all the saints we have now. And this is the real cause of the auto-destruction of the church, of the smoke of Satanas, of the water in the sinking boat. It is the Council. And Pope Benedict XVI told that. Told the Vatican II with Gaudium et Spes is an antisyllabus. And he said, the church during the Council had to accept the values of 2 centuries of the New World as he went out of the revolution, of the French Revolution, 1789. It is said by Ratzinger. But these values of 2 centuries of liberal culture are the ideas of the Masonries. They are the Catholicism liberal, the modernism. And so the church accepted them in the Council. And he said, the Council, the Gaudium et Spes, is an anti-syllabus. Is it the contrary of the syllabus? And all this because they have the idea of the evolution, evolution of the theology, of the dogma. And so, well, when St. Pius X condemned the modernism, it was good, it was useful in that time. But now, no, no more. And so now we can accept the new modernism. And so you had 250 bishops who resist against this revolution. But they were defeated because other minority, the modernists, had their friend was the Pope. So most of the bishops who do not know very well all this problematic, well, if the Pope wants that, we follow the Pope, that's all. The authority in the church is very important. And so we are where we are now. But what is very great is that Bishop Lefebvre, for 18 years, explained us the problem. And he used, for instance, diplomacy with the Vatican. But this diplomacy with the Vatican was a proof that there was no hope with the Vatican. And that the only possibility was to separate ourselves from the conciliar church. And this separation occurred in 1988 with the consecrations of 4 bishops. Of course, much diplomacy, much prudence, much. But Bishop Lefebvre had a full success. 95 of people, of the faithful, follows Bishop Lefebvre and accept the consecrations of 1988. And now, in more or less the same time, the successors of Bishop Lefebvre are doing exactly the same way, but on the reverse, on the contrary. They are now, for 18 years maybe, they are convincing the priests of the Saint Pius X and the faithful that we have to go back to the conciliar church. We have to reconciliate with them. We have to be recognized Catholics by them. This is a madness, because he thinks that he will convert them. Why not to convert the devil? And Bishop Feli once told us in the seminary in Argentina, he wants a stamp, a seal. You are Catholics. But who will give him the seal of Catholic, the etiquette of Catholic? It is like to ask a certificate of good behavior by the mob, by the bandits. It is not a very good signal, no? If the mob give you, oh yes, you are a good man, you are really a good man. Well, so it is now the aim of Bishop Feli. And there are many proofs of that. For instance, the 10th of May, some days ago, he told that the Vatican has appointed him as a judge of his priests. So it has given jurisdiction on his priest. But what jurisdiction? For the Vatican, the Society of St. Pius X does not exist. It has been suppressed. So how his superiors may receive from the Vatican, from the Pope, the authority to judge his priest? But every month there is a new fact to convince us that really the society is very near from an agreement with Rome. And that is exactly what say Monsignor Pozzo of the number 2 of the Ecclesia Dei in Rome. He says, no problem with the society. Well, Bishop Feli has to make a little arrangements within his society, but and in a very few time, little time, also he will give the decision to reintegrate, and so we shall proceed by steps. Well, one step, Bishop Feli is appointed judge. Other steps, after a cordial meeting with Cardinal Müller, who do not accept the perpetual virginity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, but who is the guardian of the faith in the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith in the Vatican, and who wrote a book about theology of the liberation, communism, Marxism, with the inventor of the theology of liberation, Father Gutierrez from Lima in Peru. This man, Entonces, has cordial greetings with Bishop Feli. And they were all right to proceed by steps. One of these steps, the visit of the seminaries of the fraternity by bishops, ecumenical bishops, that of course will defend the council, exactly the contrary of the work of Bishop Lefebvre. It is like if you open the door of the chicken yard to a fox, and the fox do not kill one chicken to eat, and no, it kill everything, no? And other step, in Argentina. In Argentina, the Cardinal Poli told to the Argentinian government Yes, this society of Saint Pius X is a Catholic organization, a diocesan organization. So you can help them for the migration visa of the foreign priests. Well, so if the society is Catholic, of course, for the Argentinian government, it is administrative, of course. But for the cardinal, it is doctrinal. It's apparently canonical. If I say, if the cardinal say, yes, this society is Catholic, this is not administrative. This is doctrinal, this is, it is, and so, and of course, if the cardinal did that alone, all the bishops of Argentina will say, ah, you are a traitor, you are a crypto lefebrist, you are, we did not that. And of course, the cardinal will say, ah, no, no, I just obey. I obey the nunciature, I obey my predecessor, the Pope Francis, who was cardinal, archbishop, and in Buenos Aires, and who is the boss. He is the boss, yes, he is the boss now in Buenos Aires. He have just seen 2 hours the president of the Argentinian. And so it is the society with a signature or without a signature, but somebody has to write a letter to the cardinal to be recognized. And generally, the letters have a signature, of course. So they say they do not sign anything, but it's the same thing. And that comes from Rome. And so somebody in Rome has asked to the Pope Francis that the society in Buenos Aires should be recognized as Catholic. Conciliar Catholic. Catholic liberalism, modernist Catholic. And so in Rome we are recognized. That's and tomorrow they will say in Australia or in Germany or in a diocese, no, they are Catholic. Well, so after in Rome they will say, well, everybody says they are Catholic, and we give them a prelature personal prelature, like the Opus Dei. And we shall be exactly as 15 groups and the diocese of Campos in Brazil, we shall have the right to tell the Mass, the traditional Mass, but we shall not say one word against the new Mass, against the Council, against the revolution in the Church, against the new religion. Not one word, as all of them do. Now, St. Peter, Institute of the Good Shepherd, all, Don Gérard, 15 of them. And the diocese of Campos, the successors of Bishop of Castromayer, are very bad now. 25 priests, all the dioceses, nuns, hospitals, schools, parishes, all, with one bishop, Bishop Rifan, who went back to Rome, and all the dioceses accept. And why that would not occur in the society of St. Pius X? We are more intelligent. Bishop Felley said, oh, we are much more strong. We are much stronger. Well, we have bishops. If now they do not critique the Vatican, or much less, then once they will be within, of course they won't say anything, of course. And that is what look for the Vatican, always. Always they have wanted us to accept Vatican II. That Vatican II is not so bad, you can interpret it in a traditional way, so you have to accept it. And of course, all the enemies of the Church, the Masons, the Protestants, the sects, the Jews, all say Vatican II is wonderful. And so, of course, the society must accept it. And that's why, till now, Bishop Feuillet could not accept it. Because the day he accepted it, many people, many priests in France and in other countries will go out of the society. And many faithful. In France, the situation is very tense. The many priests in France have no more confidence in Bishop Feuillet. Because they saw this, he says something one day, other thing other day. In Swiss, there is much skying, no? So in the sky, and that is the problem now. And we see in the Apocalypse many texts could apply to the situation now, no? They say, and it was given to the dragon to make war with the saints in the earth and to overcome them. And authority over every tribe and people and a tongue and a nation and church, why not, was given to him, to the serpent. That is the most cunning of the creatures, disguised as an angel of light, of holiness, of sanctity, of piousness, piety, etc., etc. And today, how are the authorities in the states, in our nations, in our Catholic and conciliar church, in our TV, in our press? These authorities have been given to the red dragon. It is evident, to the enemy of Christ. The devil, before the incarnation, was the enemy of Christ. And there was a war in the heaven, we read in the Apocalypse. And after, in the first verse of the Bible, we have God says, I shall put a perpetual enmity, a war, a continuous war, between you and the woman, between your sons and between her sons. And she will crush your head. And that is a war. And but always in the church, with the liberalism, some people think we have to make the peace. That was a great idea of the Council Vatican II. And now Bishop Feuillet wants to make the peace with these heretics that are occupying Rome as an army of occupation. And so we have the must to wake up the people. When the Titanic began to sink, it was a mass duty to say, everybody wake up and go out, and you have to abandon the ship. But now it's in the principle since 15 years ago. Father Schmidberger, first superior, and now Bishop Feuillet, says we are in an abnormal situation. And Father Pfluger says, Okay, okay, in Rome everything is not very good. But we too, we are in a bad situation because canonically we are bad. We are bad. That is, to go and see, I don't know, Father Schmidberger, Bishop Feuillet, we go as a new paper man in the, after the titaning is sinking, and he will say to Mister, you are now in a little
boat,
in a little boat, in the middle of the night, in the middle of the ocean. Don't you think you are in an abnormal situation? And so to be in a normal situation, you have to go back to the ship. It's incredible. They have not understand the problem, doctrinal problem of Bishop Lefebvre. Of course, if you do not understand the gravity of the doctrinal problem in the church, of course, you will think that you are in an abnormal situation. Outlaw. We are outlaw. We are vagus, vagi, independent priest. No, but we have to remember the fight of Bishop Lefebvre, all what he wrote, and in the last year of his life, he says, you have to cut, to separate yourself from the conciliar church. It is a duty for each priest that wants to keep Catholic to separate from this conciliar church that is no more Catholic. There are nothing Catholic in this church. And he was very strict. He said, you must not go and see the Saint Peter. Because one began to speak, to have beer and sympathy, and you will finish by treason. So we must follow, we must. And Father Piver have written a very good book with quotations of Bishop Feuillet, Bishop Lefebvre. And Bishop Feuillet
had banned
the book because it was a condemnation of the politics of Bishop Feuillet. So we have to stay faithful to Bishop Lefebvre and to his fight. And with the grace of God, we shall do it. And maybe we are not many, but Bishop Lefebvre, when he began, he was one bishop out of 2,500 bishops. He was alone. After there was a second one, Bishop Katzmeyer. Always we have been the little flock. But it looks like the Russian... puppets? The Russian Dolly. You have the conciliar church, then you say the Society of St. Pius X. After you have the Society of St. Pius, the resistance. But anyway, we have to remain faithful, and we shall, with the grace of God. So, courage.
Persevere. Have courage.
If you have any question.
If you have any questions.
What about Bishop Tizio? How does he feel about it?
Well, in the 1st of January of this year, he repeats this sentence of Bishop Lefebvre. It is a strict
duty
for any priest who wants to remain Catholic to separate himself from this conciliar church. And he said it twice. So I think that intellectually he sees the problem. But he is under the influence of Bishop Feuillet.
Can you tell us a little about the resistance in South America and France? How strong it is?
Well, the two countries where the resistance is strong and where there are possibilities that new people, for instance, in England, three priests have rejoined the resistance. In France, there is much inquietude, and in the States. And on the other hand, as Bishop Feuillet do not give convictions, because we are abnormal, you have many priests that go with dioceses. Six priests of the society went to the diocese of Toulon, one diocese. And 3 weeks ago, Father de la Motte went to the diocese of Versailles. So Bishop Feuillet is losing now, every time more, priests on the right that do not want to be tried, and on the left, that they say, oh, you say that we are normal, anormal, so I normalize my situation and I go with the bishop.
Do you expect many seminarians, Father, my lord?
Yes, we have three Brazilians, very serious, who are have been more than 1 year in the monastery of Benedictine monastery of Don Tomas in Brazil. We have a Mexican boy who is in his third year. He was 1 year in La Reja in Argentina, and a French boy I met soon, a good boy. And now an Italian, that Father Nitoglia of the St. Pius X was sent to the seminary. So it is matter to begin, and we shall begin in October, we shall have a seminary beginning nearby the monastery of the Dominicans of Avrier. So these young people will go as they go to a university. When Bishop Lefebvre began, he began in this way, in Lausanne, in Switzerland, in 69. And so when they see something is working, maybe some seminarians, and maybe some seminarians of the St. Pius X will come too, it's possible.
Quelle est votre opinion sur le message de Fatima?
We do believe, of course, in Fatima, and it is one of the principal motives of our hope. And of course, the Vatican had a very negative politics about Fatima, and Bishop Feuillet is not clear.
So, why did Bishop Feuillet did the funeral mass of Father Gruner if his position about Fatima?
He's very habile.
He's very smart. Any other questions? So maybe we can finish with a prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Blessed be the heart of Jesus. Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
The Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.